months, messages which have been born from entities outside of this country have encouraged young Muslims in particular and convert Muslims to engage in illegal acts which would not only undermine the security of our country that we live in, our beloved country, and our fellow citizens, but most importantly, ultimately serve to undermine our place as a community in this society.
The media is flooded with quotations and statements of people who are either half educated or not educated at all about Islam. They have the audacity to quote the Quran as if they know what the Quran is, taking certain verses, twisting the meaning, and ignoring what the Arabic language actually indicates, and passing judgments that will make Islam and the Muslim a very frightening phenomena, which is contrary to the reality.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said very clearly, very categorically, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his ashab have said very clearly and categorically that we cannot kill innocent people. There's no footnote there. There's no real exception to that.
Islam is a religion of peace, of building community, not destroying and turning it apart. It's saving life, not taking life.
Islam teaches a balance in all of our affairs, so it's not a religion that's amenable to extremism. And because of that, you don't see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving success to the advocates of extremism, to the advocates of indiscriminate violence, to the advocates of killing civilians. Where are they successful? Where are they successful? You just see one mess after another, one mess after another. And it's time for us to start cleaning up those messes, and even going beyond that, it's time for us to begin to contribute to the construction of something beautiful.
What is our state when some new fitna arises? Do we panic? Do we freak out? Do we start feeling the emotions rise to the surface? So we want to go out into the streets and yell and scream and kick up a fuss, exhibiting our own closeness to the munafiqeen? Or do we say, hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakil, and genuinely act on the basis of a true understanding of the Qur'an and the Sunnah for the interests and the further flourishing of this great Ummah of Islam?
The Fiqh Council of North America reiterates its consistent, repeated, and perpetual position in condemning any incitement of hatred, senseless, random acts of violence, or acts of terror committed by any party against any party or any other party, be it an individual, an organization, or state, and irrespective of perceived legitimacy of grievances.
That many people saying that there's so many issue of injustice taking place around the world. That is true. We acknowledge the injustice taking place around the world. But we believe there's a way to address the injustice, not by taking innocent people's life.
I am not calling on anybody to be inactive. I'm calling on people, for the Muslims of this country in particular, and the Muslims of the world, to be proactive, but not to embrace the nihilism and the anti-Islamic policies of terrorism and unwarranted violence.
This religion is not our property. This religion, we have no right to detract, to pollute, to sully the good name of Islam and the good name of our Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. We are obliged to honor that name. If you go by the name Muslim, that is a very exalted status, to be one who submits to the will of God. And it's important to not arrogate to oneself the idea that somehow you know what the will of God is.
We as Muslims are instructed to respond to tyranny and fight it in a proper manner. There is no denying that we as Muslims have to stand up for truth and for justice. There's no denying that we have to help those who are in need of our help, that we have to help the oppressed and help the poor and help the weak and help the widow and help the orphan. This is a part and parcel of being not just Muslims, but really decent human beings.